Hi, welcome to Reptile Ridge and my little piece of heaven. My small garden where more squamata drama is about to take place. This is Blobster. He's a bullfrog. They're amphibians. We're going to be studying him and seeing lots more of him this season. Squamata is the largest order of reptiles, including lizards and snakes. This is a green anole lizard, the Anolis carolinensis. He's taken up residence near my front door. He's not the same anole from last year known as Spot. He needs a name, and I'm open for suggestions. I've already given this guy a name. Meet Rusty. He's come calling for Rover. She's the female fencie, who also lives in my garden. The anole watches Rusty's every move. Rusty could be Rover's dreamboat, and the anole's worst nightmare. Rusty continues to strike a pose on the fence post, showing us why they're called fence lizards. He certainly is impressive. But will Rover find him attractive? It looks like he's got her attention. She heads off over to the pond for a better look. This is flirting 101, fence lizard style. Rusty gives it his best. He's saying to Rover, "Hey, baby, I'm your man." But it looks like Rover's saying back, "See you later, alligator lizard," another common name for this species. Then, all of a sudden, Rusty rushes her. The anole does his best to stay out of their way. Yes, it's barbaric. But this is how these guys roll. It's time for some reptilian romancing on the garden stone. But Rover doesn't seem to be too happy by this sudden flare of passion. And please, guys, don't ever try this with most human females. If you do, you may never be able to breed again. But this is how it's done in their world. Rusty's persistent and continues to show his dominance. The push-ups, like the anole's displays, are about dominance. In time, the females usually submit. However, Rover continues to be quite the challenge. The anole is now displaying a cool shade of green, showing that his stress level has decreased, knowing that Rusty's attention is no longer on him. I've lost them. There they are. And there they go. Let's give them some privacy, so they can do as nature intended, prolificate the species. Meanwhile, in the backyard, I've run into another old friend. I believe this is the female anole from last season named Jenny. Hello to the real Jenny, one of my dearest online friends. You're the best. Much love to you and yours. Now, Jenny the anole has also proven to be quite a survivor. Anoles are very territorial little animals, sometimes remaining in the same locations for years. Will Jenny continue to stay here? Or will she broaden her horizons and join the others out in the forest. This small lounge of lizards has been here in my spare parts pile since last summer. However, two new males have now taken over the space from last year's dominant male, called Rob. Rob hasn't been seen in a long time. Either he moved on or fell victim to a predator. Today, Zeus rules the roost. He appears to be the more dominant of the pair of males. It's not unusual to have two males occupying the same territory. But when it's breeding season, look out. Only one of them will be in charge then. Who will ultimately come out on top here? We'll see you again soon. Thanks for watching.